I want to tell just a few words why we are speaking English, despite it's not our mother tongue. When I was in Finland and was discussing with Finnish IT people the problems they are trying to solve, I had a feeling that guys somewhere in space and we are somewhere underground with our problem. So to share our problem with other countries, with people from other countries, we have decided in Agile Latvia to make as much as possible of our events using English. That's why we try to stick to that principle. So, I'm going to speak about requirements in Agile. I'm going to express official point of view.
Wait, you don't think official about it?
Yes, yes. It's my official point of view, since there are no any single authority in Agile. Every Agile highly paid consultant has his own view how people should implement these Agile practices and how the consult should be paid for it. So, a little bit.
It's working out.
Yeah, a little bit about myself. That's me in a better shape. So, I'm kind of enthusiast of Agile Latvia community. I'm running my own small company, NB Crew. Doesn't matter. So, and I'm a sidekick at Java User Group Latvia as well. So you can, if you have any questions, use Twitter to ask me or to follow, to read my thoughts when I have one. What is Agile at all? People trying to describe it using some methodology. Very often we are doing Scrum, that means we are Agile. Not always. I rather say if you are doing just Scrum, you are not Agile. Term Agile is quite old. It's almost 10 years old, and it was started with Agile Manifesto. If some of you haven't read it, take a minute to read it, and it's not actually important to understand what they say about, since the methodologies was already in place when these principles were refined. So guys already were working using their methodologies, and then they gathered together and came up with the term Agile. So you can use any methodology you want and be Agile if this methodology is not much important. So, what we are trying to do with Agile in software development? What is the purpose of any methodology in software development? We need to solve the problem using some software. The best way to solve the problem using software is to create some software. The best way to create the software is just to keep making it, keep programming, not writing huge documents, gather some long hours meetings, and so on. So, and then to be sure that you solved the problem, you should show your software to the customer. And if customer could tell you, okay, you solved my problem, I'm happy, then you solve it. Otherwise, okay, so everything starts with a problem, and when customer sees the problem, it could be, in his understanding, it could be like this one, it's a problem, but kind of very structured problem. When IT people comes closer, they usually see kind of like this. And how to start to work with it? Can you imagine how to describe the structure of all this logistic and other thing? Can you make a proper planning or estimation how you will solve this problem? Probably not, but you could start with very small first you need to discuss with customer how customer could describe the problem. Do customer understand what the problem is? Sometimes customers are telling, I already have an old system and I want the new one doing completely the same, but the new one. Sometimes they describe the problem in their own terms, which you do not understand at all. But anyway, you need to have a starting point. And if you would try to translate all the hieroglyphs, you will end up with tons of dictionaries, a ton of paper, a lot of paperworks, and you won't solve the problem, actually. So, the very first thing Agile proposed to start with is a user story. It has a very simple structure. It has a name, has a role, action and result. So, it sounds like this. As say, William Wallace, I want to see Scotland free. So, Scottish people could elect their king by themselves, not the English people. Okay. And acceptance criteria could be, as well, described in very simple terms. You could see how it looks. Just few sentences, and what would happen after that? Since we are talking about requirements, some of you may think that this user story already is a requirement. No, it's not. It's not a requirement, and it's... you see this guy? It's just a starting point to look for requirement. What requirement is, what is required for the customer. And starting with this user story, you probably the first thing you will do, you will start a conversation with the customer, with the business analyst maybe, domain experts and software experts, and all involved stakeholders. Then you will start some exploration of what problem is, what underlines, what customers are trying to hide from you, what they do not understand at all. So sometimes it's not only exploration, sometimes it's excavation. And after that, you can probably come up with some estimation what customer could expect, in what terms, how much it might take in terms of time. But you need to understand that in that case, in that particular case, your estimation, probability of your that your estimations are true is near to weather forecast. They might be true, might be not, but it's, again, it's a starting point. When you will explore more, you could just estimate it more properly, more precise. So when you start the estimation, you could estimate user story using t-shirt sizes. It's small, medium, large, and extra large. And there are some user stories called epics. Liberation of Scotland from English rule, it's an epic story, and there was a movie about this epic. So, and when you explore more of details of this user story, what exactly William Wallace was trying to achieve, then you could, with your team, you could say to customer, it would take 20 years or 100 years or just 1 year, in case of software development project, you could make your estimations using ideal hours or story points, doesn't matter. And probably somewhere here, you could say exact time you need. I need 3 more hours to finish this user story. And only when you completely understand what you are trying to achieve, what customer needs, you can say, okay, 2 more hours and I will finish. This user story things, usually they are written on some sticky notes, and they are integral part of different software development approaches. First one, where they were introduced, I believe, it's extreme programming. The second one is Scrum, which is quite popular right now because there are certification. In extreme programming, you cannot get any certification, but in Scrum, after 2 days course, you could become a Scrum Master. And your company could give you Scrum slaves. Canva. It's another approach which came from Japan, but we have discussed it already. Alexei made a great presentation about it, so I won't go through listening about it. So, in general part, XP, just simple picture. You see these iterations within different time intervals, minutes, hours, days, weeks, months. So, and the user story comes into this picture in release plan and iteration plan. On that level, you start working with user stories. Then, if you're trying to create an acceptance test, it could be actually acceptance, you are making this acceptance test using acceptance criteria of this user story, and so on. So Scrum use the same rounded arrows. So the base idea of Scrum that you ship something to customer every month. And you do the same routine every day. Kanban is a bit different. You have no release, you have no iterations, you just doing something, you have what you need to do, you are doing something, and then you have something done. When something is done, you ship it to your customer and he is able to use it immediately. So there are few techniques for estimations of user stories. First one is estimation wall. It's used by entire team during planning. So you have a bunch of user stories and you need to estimate which one is easy one, which one is the hardest one, and which one is quite simple. So 20 person starts with the first one. This person puts it on the wall. Next person takes next user story, and if this person believes that taking user story is harder, she puts it to the left or upper, doesn't matter. So, and after initial placement, team should or could rearrange this user stories how they believe it's, it is true, which one is harder to implement, which one is not. A more sophisticated technique of the same is the playing poker, used by card, and entire team sits around the table and each team member has his own deck of cards, and when they are discussing, they ended to discuss user stories, they should give their estimates just made by showing the card, and if entire team agree that all team members are shown the same card, then they are agreed. If there is some disagreement, that means team should discuss this user story more, because different people have different understanding of this user story and it leads to different estimates. After that discussion, if they can negotiate what they really need to do and adjust the estimates, they can start with another user story. There are some technical practices to make sure that this user story is not just words on the paper, but it's a part of software implemented. Behavior-driven development, automated acceptance tests, and continuous integration. The basic idea behind it could be found on the internet. I won't go deep into it, since there are business analysts. Sorry, no offense, but it's really technical topics, and I believe Raymond could tell you more on open space. And if he got his laptop, he can show it. So, and I told that user story is not a requirement. But what requirement is in Agile, in official point of view on requirements, in my official point of view? So, first, user story is a part of requirement, of course. It consists of description and acceptance criteria. Next one is the user story should be explored, and after that exploration, team should have some understanding how it should work and how it will be tested. So how the team will make sure that they are meeting acceptance criteria. And the third part, I believe, it's automation. Once the team made some tests, acceptance tests, that it should be automated and running in continuous integration cycle, continuously checking if newly added functionality do not break any previous previously implemented user stories first, and it allows you to keep your requirements consistent, not just one person implements one user story, another person implements another user story. When they put everything together, both user stories, both piece of software do not work. So to avoid that, you probably could have a continuous integration environment where all tests will be running to ensure that any change do not break your software. So, summary about user stories. It's just a starting point to real requirements. User story written on paper or just placed in some document or document management system. It's very easy to translate. You don't need to go through entire 50 pages document. You just could see on the wall that this user story now in development, and there are other techniques to track these activities, but it's out of the scope again. It's easy to visualize, of course. You could place this user story in mind map, on the wall, on the table, rearrange them, easily discuss it. And it's easy to calculate for user story return of investment, since user story is very basic story. And if you have implemented it, customer immediately could use it and see how actually things are happening. I know the story when guys are making games for Facebook and Russian social networks. They ship implemented functionality every week, and they could see on the next day, did they something correct, which gives them some money back, or did they just some useless work? And in case if they see that they did something useless that nobody wants to pay for, they just lost 1 week of their work. So, and that gives them flexibility, and they understand what kind of return of investment they have. So, if you are interested to learn something a little bit more about Agile approach to specification, to requirements, you could check the topics specification by example, Agile estimation, and backlog management. So, questions?
I have a question. If it will be too long, you just tell me. Let's imagine the situation that we all are investing. So we are buying stocks of companies, so IBM, Dell, whatever. We keep them in bank, right? So now bank has, anytime any of these companies are paying dividends, bank has to notify each of us that, hey, IBM is paying dividends. What do you want to do? Do you want to take them? Not. That's the use case, right? So that's the business process. Now bank in itself, there's a requirement, a basic business requirement. Each time things like stock payment happens, all users should be notified. So, however bank is built, there are many systems in bank which are involved in developing, in making sure that we are notified. So in this your user story case, how would it look like? What would be a requirement? How many user stories would be created?
Actually, my hourly rate is not that big, so you could order the consultancy services. Really, as I understand, it's not just a theoretical question, and I was a similar situation, but to answer your question, I need to explore what is going to happen in this bank. So, really, if you would like to discuss, I gladly. First hour is for free.
I guess I wanted to understand how it works in something bigger than Facebook game.
But is it possible to just give one simple use case from the story that is given? For example, it's like I'm a user A and I just verified that my phone buzzed and provided SMS.
Actually, as a software developer, I should not write user stories. I should help customer to refine the simplest case of using the software and describe it using user story form. So it's not my part of job to write for the customer. As a customer, I want...
Customer writes the user story.
We doing
it
together.
Responsible for user story. So, for example, if you would be the customer, you would be the developer. So we're still not getting any user story.
if I would be the developer and he is the customer, I would see this kid for a day and we would draw how it works. And then we will try to split some cases, case by case, and then, only then, we will try to describe it in terms of user stories.
My question was not so much about the user stories as such, but the question about the fact that there are multiple systems. There is a one business need. The customer doesn't care at the end of the day there are 15 systems involved. All he means is whenever IBM pays dividends, all of us are not spying.
So you say the customer doesn't care, so the customer cares that the user will receive this notification.
Of course he cares.
So therefore he should care that the systems work together.
Of course he should, but a business requirement, what people that run it, that are working in a bank and running the business, all they need is that you are not
spying.
They don't care.
Why? Because, why they need that?
Because that's the rule.
What's the rule? By whom?
Of the business.
That's
by
the rule
what?
Of business. That's the rule.
Will they bankrupt if they won't have this feature?
Yes. Bank cannot do the business.
So that, can they tell us how many, or maybe this is something where they will earn something more about that?
No, it just needs to happen. But the question is, many businesses...
That's not true.
It is not true. It just is
true. Regulatory requirement, yeah, and it is true.
Well, okay, so in regulatory requirement, okay. But we can implement it in 100 different ways.
But
the question is,
do you think customer cares about your opinion?
Yes.
Why?
I'm currently both as a customer and developer, yeah, so I'm... Developing
customer never cares about developer's opinion.
That's not
why?
True.
No.
That's not true.
So then you have bad customers. Sorry for that.
Every customer is bad.
So, no. Okay, sorry for your customers.
I hope that is not published anywhere.
We'll find one person who says that this customer is bad.
But
every customer, you can find an angle who will say the customer.
So that's totally separate discussion. Yes, that's about
a bit different topic. Is customer bad or
that is
do
not
clear?
No.
Okay, so to answer your question.
Hold on.
Yeah.
This the topic of this presentation is requirements and Agile, right?
Yeah.
We have been told that the user story is part of requirements, and after the user story, there's a conversation through which the real requirement is kind of explored.
Okay. So I can comment regarding your example. So I have done a lot of workshops with customers, to do these user story definitions. So we will start with the simplest case, and we'll write that, for example, what would be the simplest case? And we'll write this simplest case as one user story. Then we'll say, okay, what could be different? What's more more complex case? Then this will be another user story, and so on. So that's a typical approach.
There is one user story, 15 systems.
No. So, I'm
sorry,
telling
guys,
you what
sorry
is...
Guys,
okay.
Sorry, guys.
So
let's leave it to open space, please.